What up, everybody? Dirty Digits back again, hanging out in Scratch DJ Academy, New York City. And we're here today to talk about cleaning your fader and modding your fader. A lot of people have had problems with plastic little pieces breaking on their fader and waiting for replacement parts. So enter Infinity Faders, which is an unbreakable fader. So today we're gonna break down our 62, show you how to take the fader out, clean it, add the mod to it, and we're gonna take it from there. So we'll need a couple things before we get started. First, we need a screwdriver to take everything apart. We're gonna need a cleaning solvent. I'm gonna be using hydrogen peroxide mixed with water just to clean the gunk off the faders and get it fresh and crispy. Something to clean the gunk off the fader with. And most importantly, fader lube. WD-40 or something like that is not gonna work. You need to get approved fader lube that works with the Rane fader. I'm using keg droplets to kind of make it happen. So let's kind of zone in and we'll take it from there. I've already taken the screws off the faceplate, so I'm just gonna lift this bad boy up right here and take this out of the picture. And then you have your fader housings. And so for us to remove the crossfader, we just simply need to remove these two screws right here. All right, now that we've taken the fader out of the housing, we need to disconnect the actual connection from the back, and that can be found on the back of the fader itself. So I just need to remove this little piece right here, and simply done. And now I can really work on the actual fader modding itself. Put my faceplate down just so I don't spill anything or anything else, and we can really put the focus on here. Okay, so I'm gonna teach you how to remove, clean, and install a separate piece onto your Rane faders. So for us to do this, we have to be very, very careful. There's a couple key contacts in here that I can't touch. I need to make sure that I don't obstruct those at all. So I'm gonna flip this thing over and very carefully, while still holding onto the component board, I'm gonna remove these four screws right here. Now, this is the most important part where you need to have a certain finesse. What we need to do is we need to try to separate this component board from all these other features on the fader, because we're gonna replace this stem right here. So us separating this component board is very tricky because there's a couple contacts which are right here that we can't touch or move. So like a surgeon, I'm just gonna hold on to one and slowly remove the component board from the other one. Now the component board is removed, I have my fader parts, I can mod that. But just to show you, these little black specks right here, I need to make sure I don't touch, because that's the other end of the magnetic fader. If these things get moved, I've uncalibrated my whole crossfader, and I'm in a world of trouble. So be very mindful never to touch those two things. Now that I have that separate, I'm gonna put it away, I'm gonna forget about it, and I can really focus on the fader mod itself. Now that I have the fader disassembled, I have a little cleaning agent right here. I use a mixture of hydrogen peroxide diluted with water, but we just need to get something to clean the gunk off of these rails. If I want to clean my Rane fader and put the same piece back on, I would have to put the same cleaning agent inside of here where all the contacts go. But for us, we're not going to worry about that. We're modding it with a new Infinity fader, so we just have to make sure the rails are super clean and ready to go. So I have this cleaning agent. I'm just going to dip a little bit in here. And then just pick up my rail and just clean the gunk off of it and try to make it as clean as possible. Now everything is polished, it looks great. So I need to start to reassemble my fader. So I'm just gonna go through the same steps in reverse. We can get this out of the way. The rail's in their place. Now I have everything set and complete. Make sure that my bouncers are set, the fader can bounce back and forth. This little area right here, these little plastic pieces are made to house this. So as I place this back on, I'm gonna make sure to get these little plastic pieces right on the outside of these contacts. So again, I need to be super careful when I'm reassembling. If you guys are ever lost and you don't know which direction to go on the actual Rane board itself, it shows you what the fader should look like, where the stem is, where the main piece goes, and where the other rail is. So I'm gonna get my fader, my stem, right over the diagram on top of it to simply put it back on spot. So let's do that. So again, this is where it gets very tricky. And lay it back down. Right where they need to be. Now that I've got it, I have a lot of pressure. I'm gonna fold it over and just get a simple bolt in there. Just so I don't have to worry about anything else. Awesome. So now I have my fader reassembled with my Infinity fader on it. And all I need to do before I get this thing back in is I need to put a little bit of fader lube on it. This is where a lot of DJs can overdo it. All we want to do is put a very, very small amount. If I put one drop here, one drop on this rail, and work the fader back and forth, I should get an even amount of lube. If I accidentally put too much on, it's going to catch more dust, more gunk, more everything else, and I'm going to have to go through this process way more than I need to. that's all I need to do. And I'm just gonna work the fader to get a nice bounce to it. And this thing is already, you can see as I kind of turn it side to side, it's ready to go. So the last step of what I need to do is just put this back in. So once again, I'm gonna make sure that I have these connected. So I'm gonna bring this in, make sure I have the grooves on top, and it should snap right back in place. I've got that set. All I'm gonna do is reassemble the fader, bolt it back in, and we'll give it a test run. So now that I have it in and I have it the right way, the fader should have the same exact movement. Let's get this set back up. Get my fader caps locked back on. So now we have the fader in. I've got the faceplate, everything screwed back in place. You need to make sure that everything is tight. We're all set. It's time to put it to the test. I'm